What is up? Flutter Mentor here again, and today we're going to find out how to easily add elevation to any widget. Let's do this. So as you can see, this is pretty straightforward, just a container, a list tile, and a text, and we're going to add a drop shadow effect to each of them. There are other ways to do it, but I'm just going to focus on the simplest one. So you just wrap the container with a material widget. And what is a material widget? I just love Flutter's definition, a piece of material. I don't know who wrote this, but genius. But very basically, the material widget is responsible for clipping, elevation, and ink effects. But today we're just going to focus on elevation. But what the material class really is, it's a widget used to define a UI element respecting material rules. And what is material design? Very basically, it's just a material design created by Google. Just like the iPhone has certain design styles that are very unique to the iPhone, Google also wanted to bring its own version of that to Android. And sure, if you read this, it says iOS here as well, but let's face it, it's mostly an Android thing. If there isn't anything that's trying to unite the design of Android apps all across, then we would end up with very different designs, and that would lead to poor user experience, which is exactly the opposite goal of creating great apps. And in order to provide great user experience, a drop shadow can always help. So let's do that right now. Just come over to the material widget, use Control plus space, and here are the properties of it, and there's a color option. Let's give it a color, a red one, and save it, and as you can see, nothing has changed. But if I delete this right here and I save it now, then it would change. I'm going to keep this. I'm just showing you some things that you can do with the material widget. You can also use this to define the text style. For example, let's increase the font size to say 30 and watch how the text widget right here, that is the child of the center, that is the child of a container, is affected by the material, which is the parent widget of all of them. And interestingly, even the text color changed. Let me remove this because it looks way worse now. And now something else could be, for example, the border radius. You could very easily change it like this, but you would have to remove the container color for it to happen, like so. If we keep the color, then the border radius does not come into effect. Just some details about this widget, just to make sure that you understand it. But let's get to the elevation. It's literally as simple as doing this and saving it, and there is the elevation right there. And just in case you can't see it somehow, let me make it 50. It's even bigger now. And something very interesting is that you can change the color, like so. Shadow color, let's make it something ridiculous, like purple accent, and watch the color change. And that's literally all you gotta do. I can come over here and wrap this list tile with a material widget, give it an elevation of 20, for example, and also a color, by the way, seeing as it's see-through right now. Let's make it deep orange, save it, and I don't know if you can see it because of the text. Let me give you a little sized box so you can see it better. As you can see, it's right here, but in case you can't see, let's change the color again to something ridiculous like green. And boom, there is a really strange shadow underneath the list tile right now. And I'm gonna do the same for the text widget, but it's not gonna look as good because it's just a text widget. But check it out. I'm gonna save it, and there is the shadow. Looks pretty weird to me. And once again, obviously the text style property would also come in very handy here. And the reason this is relevant is in case you have a lot of texts that eventually are children of the material widget, and then you can just set a text style for all of them in one place. You'll probably not use this property too much, but just in case you ever come to a point where you would need it, where it would help you, I just decided to mention it again. Let's make this bold. And apparently the text always changes to white when you're using the material widget's text style. That's very interesting. But if I give it a color like colors.yellow, nope, still white. So now you know, if you use a text style from the material widget and you want the text to be black, you gotta do it yourself. There it is, bold, black, and with a yellow background. All very easily implemented thanks to the material widget, and obviously all of them with drop shadows or elevations, whatever you want to call it. So as you can see, this widget can also be very interesting, and it's kind of similar to container, I would say. But the goal of the material widget is essentially to help you give some material details to your widgets and etc. It's not the most used widget out there, but sometimes it can be quite handy. So I hope you liked this video, and if it did help you in any way, please don't forget to hit that like button. And then just in case you want to keep on learning Flutter, also hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. That's it for now. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.